Back to my new lecture. In this particular lecture, we are going to derive an equation for LMTD for parallel flow heat exchanger. You will be knowing that what is LMTD. LMTD is a logarithmic mean temperature difference. This is one of the methods for the analysis of the heat exchanger. And parallel flow heat exchanger is heat exchanger in which both fluid, that is cold fluid and hot fluid, they are moving parallel to each other. You can see this figure. In this particular figure, I have shown you tube in tube type of heat exchanger. Here, this is the inner tube through which I have shown hot fluid is flowing, whereas the outer tube in which cold fluid is flowing. So hot fluid flow is shown by the red color, so this is moving from left to right, whereas cold fluid also is shown by the blue color. So hot fluid is moving from left to right as well as cold fluid is moving from left to right. As both fluid is moving in the same direction, that's what is called as parallel flow heat exchanger. Now we are going to derive an equation for this. Let's consider the graph for this one. So I have drawn a graph on the downside here like this. Here on the x-axis, we have taken as a length of the heat exchanger, whereas on the y-axis we have taken a temperature. And here we have drawn a two curve. This is the first curve for the cold fluid and this is the another curve for the hot fluid. Here in the heat exchanger, when both fluid are flowing forward, temperature of this fluid which is inside the tube will be high, whereas the fluid which is outside the tube will be less. So because of this temperature difference, heat will be flowing from hot fluid to cold fluid. Means hot fluid is losing the heat, whereas cold fluid is gaining the heat. On the other word, I can say that when hot fluid is moving from inlet to outlet, the hot fluid temperature will go on reducing, whereas when cold fluid moving from inlet to outlet, the temperature of cold fluid will go on increases. And this is shown by the graph here. This is the cold fluid graph, whereas this is the hot fluid graph. In the cold fluid graph, I have shown this is TCI, that is cold fluid inlet temperature. Here also I have shown that the cold fluid inlet temperature. The cold fluid inlet temperature is shown by TCI, whereas the hot fluid inlet temperature is shown by THI. Now cold fluid inlet temperature TCI, as the fluid moves forward, it will go on increases and at the outlet we will get TCO, that is cold fluid outlet temperature. You can see that the temperature is go on increases continuously. Whereas for hot fluid, the temperature goes on reduces. At the inlet it is a THI, that is hot fluid inlet. H indicates hot fluid, I indicates inlet. And as it moves forward, the hot fluid temperature goes on reduces and finally we get a THO. So here, for the hot fluid, temperature goes on reduces. For the cold fluid, temperature goes on increases. The difference in a temperature of the fluid at the inlet is called a delta T1. I repeat, delta T1 is difference in a temperature of hot fluid and cold fluid at the inlet. So I have written here delta T1 is equal to THI minus TCI. Whereas the difference in a temperature at the outlet is denoted by delta T2, and that is we have written as a THO minus TCO. So delta T2 is THO minus TCO, whereas delta T1 is THI minus TCI. For the analysis of the fluid, I am going to concentrate on the small area. So that is what the DA shown here. This is the small area, and by considering this small area, I am going to derive an equation. For the small area, let us see what is the temperature differences. For the small area, the temperature difference for the hot fluid is a dTh, and as the slope is negative, so we have written here a minus dTh. Difference in the temperature of cold fluid is a positive dTc. Why positive? Because slope is positive here. Here slope is negative and that's why it is minus dTh. Here slope is positive and that's why it will become plus dTc. So this is all about a figure. You should understood all the terminology and then only we can go for the derivation of this. Now let's go for the derivation. I'll derive the equation for this. Let's consider the first equation. I am going to consider as Q is equal to, we are knowing some of the standard terms we are going to use here. The Q is equal to UA delta T. Now what is term here? U is overall heat transfer coefficient, A is the surface area and delta T is the temperature difference. This is the standard equation. Generally, we are knowing Q is equal to HA delta T. When we write H, that is heat transfer coefficient. And when I write U, that is overall heat transfer coefficient. In this equation, what is delta T? Delta T is equal to hot fluid temperature, that is TH, minus cold fluid temperature. TH indicates T is the temperature, H is for hot fluid, T is the temperature for cold fluid. Okay, so if I take a derivative of this as D of delta T, so what I added here is D. So if I add D here, on the right side also it will become DTH minus DTC. So what we have taken, D of delta T is equal to DTH minus DTC. The another equation, that standard equation, that DQ is equal to MCP delta T, that we are knowing it. So the equation is MC DT. So rather than delta T, I am going to write DT. We can write it quite simple. Now we should know that heat loosened by the hot fluid is nothing but heat absorbed by the cold fluid. In the other term, heat lost by the hot fluid is nothing but heat gained by the cold fluid. If this equation I applied for the hot fluid, the equation will become dq. Rather than m, I will write mh, which indicate mass flow rate of hot fluid, ch, which indicates specific heat of hot fluid, and dth. So this is difference in a temperature of hot fluid. Now in above equation, what I am going to do is assume that capital CH, new term I am going to define, the capital CH is nothing but MH into CH. What is MH? MH is mass flow rate of hot fluid, and small CH is nothing but specific heat of hot fluid. So capital CH is MHCH. Capital CH also called as heat capacity. Okay, and this DTH is negative, as we have seen here. So here you can observe that here the DTH is negative because of negative slope, and DTC is a positive. So as this negative, I am going to write this symbol here. So now my equation will become, in the above equation, if I put MHCH is nothing but CH, so it becomes DQ is equal to CH, and DTH is negative, so negative sign I am going to write here, and this will become DTH. This is the equation we have got. And why we have marked here negative? Because of its negative slope on the figure. Okay, now rearrange the term for DTH. So DTH is equal to, so this CH will go on this side, so it will become DQ by CH, and it will be negative. Okay, so let's consider this is equation number 1. Okay, similar term we are going to write for cold fluid. Means here we are written DQ is equal to MHCH DTH. Same, the heat loss by hot fluid is nothing but heat gained by cold fluid, and that's why DQ is equal to the MC, same equation I am writing, MC CC DTC. Okay, here also MCCC I am going to replace by capital CC, and DTC is a positive. In this particular figure we have seen that the DTC is positive, so I am going to maintain a positive sign there. So the equation will become DQ is equal to capital CC, capital CC is MCCC, and DTC, and it's a positive, so this will maintain a positive. Similar to here, rearrange the term for DTC. Now here we have arranged term for DTH, and now I am going to arrange term for what? DTC. So DTC is equal to DQ upon CC. So we have got, this is second equation. So first equation we have got DTH is equal to minus DQ by CH. DTC is nothing but a DQ by CC. Now these two equations I am going to put here. So if I put here, then what we'll get as D of delta T is equal to, D of delta T is equal to, instead of this DTH, what I am going to write now, instead of DTH, I am going to write minus DQ by CH, and instead of DTC, what I am going to write is DTC equation. So DTC equation is minus DQ by CC. This is the equation we have got it. Now in this particular equation, I am going to take DQ as outside. So if I take a DQ outside, then what will be an equation? So next equation is Next equation is in this. What I am going to write is d of delta t, d of delta t. So minus dq I am going to take outside. So if I take minus dq outside, then what we will get is inside bracket, here you can see that inside bracket is 1 upon ch. So this will become 1 upon ch plus 1 upon cc. This is an equation we have got, and this is the equation number 3. So third equation we have got. Now the next task for us is to find out value of ch and value of cc. So for finding value of capital CH and capital CC, we are going to do the procedure. First of all, we are going to do the procedure for capital CH. So for finding capital CC and capital CH, I am going to use the formula as heat transfer Q. Once again, heat transfer Q is equal to MC delta T, that we are knowing. Delta T is the temperature difference between hot fluids. So if this equation I applied for hot fluids, so it will become MHCH difference in a temperature of hot fluid. So we know that hot fluid temperature at the inlet, it will be high, and as it passes forward, it will go on reducing from this particular figure. So here we are knowing the hot fluid temperature at the inlet is high, and as I move forward, it will be less. So when I'm going to take delta T, so higher temperature minus lower temperature for the hot fluid. So here, higher temperature is THI minus THO. This is what we have written. Then, Q is equal to, we know that MHCH, this MHCH is capital CH, whereas THI minus THO remain as it is. Now, rearrange the term for CH. Why we are rearranging for CH? Because I have to put here. So, rearrange the term for CH. CH is equal to, this term will go on this side, Q upon THI minus THO. So we have got a first equation for the CH, and that is the equation number 4. Next task is find out equation for CC. For finding equation for CC, similar procedure I am going to do for CC. For CC, I am going to write the same equation which we have written here, but for the cold fluid. So it will become MC CC. This will become TCI minus TCO. That's the equation. Same equation I have written for the cold fluid. But here, the one thing we have to remember, for the cold fluid, when we are going to take temperature difference, the higher temperature minus lower temperature. For the cold fluid, which is the higher? At the inlet, it is less temperature, and at the outlet, we are getting high temperature. So it must be written as TCO minus TCI. So I'll write here as TCO minus TCI. Okay, so do the same simplification what we have done here. So Q is equal to MCCC, I am going to write CC, whereas this will be remain as a TCO minus TCI as it is. Now, same step what we have done here. So rearrange the term for CC is equal to, so this will go on this side. So it will become Q upon TCO minus TCI. And this is next equation we have got, equation number 5. Now, to put in this particular equation CH and CC, we have find out value of CH, value of CC. Next task is put CH and CC in the equation number 3. So let's write put CH and CC from equation 4 and 5. So equation number 4 is for CH, equation number 5 is for CC, in equation number, that the equation number is the 3. So let's put in equation number 3. So let's put it. So after putting an into the equation, what we'll get is the equation as this one. D of delta t is equal to minus dq into bracket is 1 upon ch. So we are doing 1 upon ch value. So here we have seen the 1 upon, I am putting CH and CC value here. So CH value is this one. CH value is this one. CC value is this one. So here, instead of CH and CC, what I am going to put? I am going to put this CH and CC. So after putting, what we will get an equation is Q upon THI minus ThO, that is the value of CH, plus 1 upon Q by value of CC. The value of CC is TCO minus TCI. So this is what the equation we have got. Now simplifying this particular equation, how to simplify? The D of delta T, D of delta T is equal to minus dQ I'll keep as it is. This I'll take on upper side. So equation will become THI minus THO divided by Q plus TCO minus TCI divided by Q. Okay, this is what equation we have got it. Now I have to put the value of dQ. dQ is the heat transfer for the small area which we have considered, and heat transfer for that particular small area is nothing but U dA delta T. It's similar to Q is equal to UA delta T. Rather than A, I have written dA because we are going to do the analysis for the small area. So which small area? I'll show here. The small area which we have considered, this one. So for this small area, what is the heat transfer is dQ. And what is the formula will become? Formula will become dQ is equal to UdA delta T. Delta T is the temperature difference for that particular fluid. So now put this into above equation and take Q outside. So what will become an equation now? The equation will become like this. D of delta T is equal to, rather than minus dQ, I am going to put minus UdA delta T. This Q I will take on outside, so this is Q into bracket. Into bracket I will get THI minus THO plus TCO minus TCI. Okay, so this is what equation we have got it. Now, next simplification. What is the next simplification? The delta T terms I am going to put on left side, whereas the other term on the right side. Means this delta T I am going to put on this side. So the equation will become d of delta t divided by delta t is equal to minus u dA by q into bracket it will become THI, bracket I am going to remove it, THI minus THO plus TCO minus TCI. Okay, so these brackets I have removed it. Okay, now this was for the small area dA. This was for the small area. So if I have to determine the performance of complete heat exchanger by this, then I have to go for the integration. So let's integrating above equation. Integrating above equation. Integrating above equation. So when we are going to integrate above equation, in this there is a d of delta T and here there is a dA. So the delta T varies from where to where, that we have to check with the figure. So let's refer this particular figure once again. Here the delta T is going to vary from delta T1 to delta T2. Okay, so here is delta T1 to delta T2. If I consider this term here at this point, there is area will be 0, and as I go on this side area will become A. Okay, so as I move forward the area will go on increases, because the area is what? Perimeter into the length. So if I consider length here, length is 0. So perimeter into 0 length will become area as 0. So here area will be 0. Whereas when I come to this one, so we have covered the length A, length L, and that's why area will become A. So at the entry area will be 0. At the exit area will be A. At the entry, the temperature difference is delta T1. At the outlet, what we are getting temperature difference is delta T2. So delta T varies from delta T1 to T2, whereas area varies from 0 to A. This gives you limits. For the area, limit is 0 to A. For the delta T, limit is delta T1 to delta T2. So considering that particular limits, I am going to integrate now. So let's consider integration of d of delta T divided by delta T. Delta T varies from delta T1 to delta T2. These are the limit, is equal to integration of minus u dA by q. dA varies from 0 to A into bracket. Into bracket, I am going to write THI, this THI minus TCI. So I can write like this. THI minus TCI. Okay. Plus or I'll make it minus. I'll make it minus. So minus THO. So this minus sign of THO I have taken outside. So it has become positive. And I'm going to write this one. So when we are going to write this one, so this is positive sign, but at the outside we are taking negatives. This will become negative TCO. Okay, so this is what an equation we have got. Okay, so THI minus TCI minus THO minus TCO. Now integrating this particular equation. So how to integrate this? This will become 1 upon delta T d delta T. And integration of 1 upon delta T is ln of delta T. The integration of this 1 upon delta T is ln of delta T. Whereas limit for this is delta T1 to delta T2. That we are knowing it. Is equal to. Here, integration of dA is A. Okay. So here A, where limit of A varies from what? 0 to A into all other term as it is. All other term is what? Minus U by Q into bracket THI minus TCI minus THO minus TCO. This is the equation we have got. Now let's go for another simplification. Now put the limit here. So when we are going to put a limit over here, what we'll get is, after putting a limit, so it will become delta T2 ln of delta T2 minus ln of delta T1. Okay, so here ln of delta T2 minus ln of delta T2 T1. So I am going to write as ln of delta T2 minus ln of delta T1, means what? I can write here as downside delta T1. So this is rule of logarithm, that when we are having ln of delta T2 minus ln of delta T1, so I can take a ratio. So we have taken a ratio here, is equal to here, if I put the limit here, if I put the limit, so this will become A minus 0 is A. Okay, so the equation will become minus U A, getting this one will be A minus 0 is A, U A by Q into, now here we are having THI minus TCI, TCO minus TCI. THI minus TCI can be replaced by delta T1, so that we are knowing. So here THI minus TCI is delta T1 and THO minus TCO is delta T2, that I am going to put in the equation now. So here, rather than THI minus TCI, I am going to put delta T1 minus THO minus TCO, that I am going to put delta T2. So this is what equation we have got next. Now this minus sign I am going to take inside. So if I take this minus sign inside, so it will become ln of delta T2 by delta T1 is equal to UA by Q, this taken inside. So if this is taken inside, so it will become delta T2 minus delta T1. If this goes inside, so this will become minus, this will become plus. So it is plus delta T2 minus delta T1. Now rearrange this equation, Q is equal to all others. So Q I am going to take on this side. So Q is equal to, Q I have taken this side, this will be taken on this side. So the equation will become now U into A into bracket, this will remain as it is. So delta T2 minus delta T1 divided by what? This I have transferred on this side. So this will become ln of delta T2 by delta T1. So this is, we have got an equation. Now let's consider this particular equation, and this is the equation number. If I check the equation number, so this is equation number 6. Similar equation I can write as U of UA into delta T LM. What is delta T LM? This is LMTD, logarithmic mean temperature difference. Some of the book they are writing as straightway LMTD. So you can put LMTD or delta T LM. Okay, so if I compare the equation number 6 and 7 now, compare equation number 6 and 7. So if you compare equation number 6 and 7, what will get it? So from this particular equation, I can write at delta T LM is equal to, so this term, this complete term must be equal to this term. So it will be delta T2 minus delta T1 divided by ln of delta T2 by delta T1. So this is what an equation we have got. LMTD for parallel flow heat exchangers. So this also called as LMTD for parallel flow heat exchanger. Parallel flow heat exchanger. In this particular equation, delta T2 is the temperature difference at the exit. The temperature difference at the exit is the THO minus TCO that we are doing it. This delta T1, delta T1 is the temperature difference at the entry. So temperature difference at the entry will become THI minus TCI, and the same term delta T2 and delta T1 is written here. So this equation will give you the logarithmic mean temperature difference for parallel flow heat exchanger. Thank you very much for listening.